Okay, first is entering and editing a formula. Okay, entering a new formula into a worksheet appears to be a straightforward process. So first is select in the cell. So a cell is any intersection. For instance, in my case, yung cursor or yung aking cell is nasa D6 and nakikita nyo sa name box. Let's say I would type figures here for okay, these are labels or description. These are numbers. So again, as a review, whenever you type labels, automatically they are aligned to the left. Ayan, naka-align left yan sila. When you type numbers or figures, naka-align to the right naman with respect to accounting formats. Wherein your number has to be aligned sa ones, tapos tens, hundreds, ganyan. And then, in entering a formula, all formula in Excel always starts with an equal sign. So, yung gagawin ko dito is magsusum in lang ako para mas maklaro. Ayan, when you enter a formula, first is you prefix it with equal sign, then followed by operands and operator, and then you press enter to confirm. So you start with an equal sign. Since I'm going to take the difference between actual and budget, I'll just click on the budget. Notice, yung nag-appear sa F10 is D7. D7. Ito yon, referring to the value 120 minus E7, referring to the value 180, you get negative 60. Copy mga students. So, ganun lang ha. Equals. Then you may use the arrow. Ayan, D8. That is operand to the left. Then followed by minus, which is your operator. You press arrow again. Now we have E8 naman and then enter.
Progress.
Copy?
Yes, ma'am.
Ganun lang siya. Or you could also make use of the fill handle or autofill button. You could find it at the bottom of the cell. This is a formula cell, di ba? Formula cell, ito yung content niya is equals D8 minus E8. Ayan, notice that when the autofill handle is used, ayan, I would copy this formula below. You call this formula being copied using the fill handle as relative referencing. When you say relative referencing, nagre-relate siya whether you copy the formula from one column to another. So column yung basis niya. From top to bottom in a column, or if you copy a formula from left to right in a row. So, ganoon yung relative referencing, di ba? Yung ating formula is sa column F, row 7, tapos kukopyahin mo yung same formula sa row 8, 9, 10. Relative referencing yung tawag dyan. Wherein, nagbabari lang siya sa, eto, kung tingnan nyo sa taas, sa formula bar natin, we have here D7 minus E7. Then, sa baba niyan, D8 minus E8 followed by D9 minus E9. Ibig sabihin, nagbabari lang siya or nagre-relate siya sa row. Papanao gabi. So, dito, we have a formula here which is D10 minus E10. So, pag niligyan ko to ng value, patos. Nagyan ko ng value dyan na 500 and 250, 251. Ayan. That is relative referencing using the autofill handle. Pero kung yung ikokopyahin mo is a constant value. O, ganyan yung magiging itsura niya. And since wala siyang reference into any cell.
Preston mula sa langit. Sinuntok ng dalawang beses ng gusto. Sa isang igla.
O magkaiba pag nagkopya kita it. Formula, constant na value, ha? Magkaiba yon. So again, when you enter a formula, you always start with equal sign followed by an operand combined with operators. And lastly, you press enter to confirm. Next, however, Excel has three different input modes. And you could determine how it interprets certain keystrokes and mouse action. So, siyempre, since hindi natin ma-figure kung magagamit ba ng arrow keys o purely keyboard lang or mag-incorporate ng mouse action yung ating user. So, in view of that, we have several types of input mode using the keyboard or using the mouse. Yung keyboard, it is in relation with the arrows kasi for referencing nga of the cells, page up and page down. And then pwede rin gumamit syempre ng mouse. So, when you enter a label such as this one, ito, budget, natatype ikaw, just make notice of the status bar at the bottom left of our window. So, every time you type there, ito, none. From ready, when you start typing a label or a number, naka-enter mode ka, oh. Enter mode siya. Okay, another. If you're going to type a number, ulit, tignan mo lang from ready, I type 58 here, ayan, nag-enter mode ka. So, every time you key in, whether a formula, a function, a label, or a number, you are switching from ready mode to enter mode. That's one of the input modes available in Excel. Another is when you enter a formula, say may value tayo dito. Ayan, when you enter a formula, may formula ko, tagali, i-remove ko lang ha. Okay. That is an equal sign. Ayan, naka-enter mode ka. And when you use your arrow in order to move to cell D11, ayan, notice that the ready mode changes to point mode. So every time you use arrow in a formula, ayan, minus abimana, and naka-enter mode ka makaroon, click na kundi ka na sa E11, man puro lata E11 da. Delete. Click naton sa D11 minus E11. Ayan. Since nag-click ako sa D11, nag-change siya into point mode. So, ganun yung combination. Arrow keys, page up, page down, or even if you're trying to, let's say, we'll try a function naman, function sum, this time, I'm going to select the entire budget amount. Ayan, tignan nyo ngayon yung aking status bar, naka-point mode ako. So kahit pa yan ay range din, nagpo-point mode din siya. And enter. Page up, page down, arrow keys, or even clicking the mouse in a cell or a range changes your input mode into point mode. Another is the edit mode. So edit mode then is also important in Excel kasi yung label is regarded as a cell. So difference is contained of several characters, di ba? Ang i-type mo. Kasi we had this view na if we are editing a text or a label in Excel, we had this idea sa Microsoft Word niya. Para sa Abimana, hi, budget. Budgeted, Abimana. So madugang kagat ED ron. Pag-click mo takarag, nag-type ikot ED, hay naduga, ah, pero previous. So kasi sa Excel, abe, hay gina, account, take into account na na nga single value ro pwedeng store di karo yon. So the tendency, if you wanted to edit a cell content, you had to enter the edit mode. And that is by pressing F2. Ayan, F2. So yung gagawin mo dito is, ayan, budget, then pindutin si Intagon. Ayan, yung ating F2 is nasa, anong ani? Nasa keyboard. Ito, yung ating F2. Ipindutin mo yan. Ayan. Notice na right away, nag-change yung ating cell into a cursor right after the letter T wherein you could, diba, add ED for budgeted. Ayan siya. To edit a value or number, hindi pwedeng basta na lang mag-type dyan sa 120. Gusto mong gawin yung 1020, pindutin mo muna yung F2 and then click sa gitna ng 1 and 2. Type 0 and press enter. Ito kung gagawing 500, ayan, press F2. Ayan, right now, it changes into an edit mode. Then you could move your cursor. Ayan. O, oh, diba? And enter. Ganon. So, sa keyboard, it laptop. The letters ag numbers ay naka, ano nga nila, nakaka-combine. So, what you do is, instead of pressing F2 lang, ay may iya kitang function. Diba? May iya kitang Fn nga, no? A function. So, you combine that, you press Fn together with F2. Para it will direct you into the edit mode. Relative referencing. So, ano ba? Relatives. Ah, referencing. Another way to enter into edit mode is by using your mouse. Simply double click. Ayan, oh. And then, point to the position. Ganon. Relatives na. And enter, syempre. Kuha nyo, students?
Yes, po, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Dati ka rin, intuwa. Kung amat malabi ako magamit laptop, gali, ginapindot pataro. FN, hag F2 kung nag-function ka. Okay. So, those are the different input mode. Ito ay enter, point, and edit. So, F2 lang yan. Napaka-importante yan sa Excel. F2 or double click using your mouse. You could also try editing using the formula bar. Ayan o, dito o. Kasi di ka, ako tabi diretsot, adi ka na double click, ag iya mismo sa cell. But you could also refer on the formula bar dito sa taas. Pwede man doon. Here you go. Pwede man sa ibabaw ka mag-edit. There, uppercase. Ayan, so that's another way Next topic is arithmetic formulas. So when we say formula, we have here the primitive operators, mathematical operators, addition, subtraction, ayan, negation, multiplication, division, percent, and exponentiation. Okay, we also have examples like equals 10 plus 5, the result is 15. May tanong? Easy. Negation naman equals negative 10. Your result is negative 10. Multiplication 10 times 5 is 50. Okay. Percentage 10% is 0.1. 10% is 0.1. Right now, okay, meron tayong ano nga nito? Numbering style wherein you could increase decimal. Ayan siya. Decrease decimal or switch to comma style. Increase, decrease. Ganun. We also have accounting format or currency. Meron tayong mga choices dito. English, Philippines, and English, US. Ayan, atong itry. Okay, para alam nyo anong gagawin. Huwag ina-type pa rin ha. Kung ka-type ikaw at anong anira ho? $20. Bukot makara mag-type at $20. Eh, sus. Okay. Proper nga way, kung nakita nyo atong $20 nag-align sa left, ibig sabihin mga students, that is regarded by Excel as a label. At pag-label yan, that is string, di yan numbers. So, para proper, you just type it without the dollar sign. And then, you will format it under number, groupings. You look for currency, may arrow dyan, pointing downward. Ayan. Perfect. Kuha?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Ko ha, magkaiba yung numbers natin tsaka labels. Kaya dapat tandaan yan is mga basics lang yan, mga preliminaries lang yan. Pero pwedeng maka-encounter kayo ng problem pag hindi nyo alam yung basic na ganyan. I will try the exponentiation naman. Equals 5 raised to 2. So 5 times 5 is 25. Galing no? 5 raised to 2. 5 there is D9. Then 2 is E11. Most of these operators are straightforward. But if the exponential operator might require further explanation, the formula equals x raised to y means that the value x is raised to the power of y. For example, the formula 3 raised to 2 produces the result 9. So that means 3 times 3. 3 raised to 3 means 3 times 3 times 3. 5 raised to 3 means 5 times 5 times 5. So, ganun lang siya. Next page tayo. Using naman the comparison operator. A comparison formula is also a statement which compares two or more numbers, whether that is a string, cell, or cell contents, functions, or function results. If the statement is true, the result of the formula is given the logical value true, which is equivalent to any number basta bukon zero. So sa Java, abi hay ro true hay 1, agro false hay 0. Iya sa Excel, 0 ro false, ag maskin aling value, basta may value na positive hay true. Have here a table. Ayan. Equal to equals 10 equals 5. Kuha niya yan? Loresto, example for equal to. Equals 10 equals 5. So, palagi, formula ito na ginagamitan natin. Pag formula, you always start with equal sign. So, operand na 10 tsaka 5 is being compared using the equal to symbol, which is ito. So, ito is 10 greater than 5? That's why your result is false. Second example, is 10 equal to 5? Is 10 greater than 5? You get true. Is 10 less than 5? False. Ayan, na-discuss ko na sa Java, oh. Is letter A greater than or equal to B? No. Haman yan eh. Ano nga nito basis? A, di ka na. And B. Equals A greater than B. Your answer is false. So, ano yung basis niya? We have the ASCII. American Standard Code for Information Interchange wherein lahat ng letters, lowercase man or uppercase, may equivalent na decimal number. Kaya, doon do point kung haman, kung mag-alt 165 kita, hayro 165 actually is equivalent to inye. Alt 48, that is equivalent to 0. Alt 97 is equivalent to letter A nga lowercase. Alt 98 is equivalent to B na lowercase. So, gina-compare na actually kara is 97 and 98. That's why you get false. Copy mga student. So, is 97 greater than 98? Ay, no, Ron. Ay, kung daywa. Daywang ka letter A. Ay, ay, kung daywang ka letter B, ano nangyari, mga students? Ba? False pa din. D16 greater than, so roonang value atong obrahon, dayang hauna, bailuhan natin it higher. Naroon true yun, imaw. Siyempre roona, gagi. Kung mag-compare kita, Abby, mag-compare kita using ASCII code, hay, gumpisa gid sa left to right. So, una, ano yung compare? Pangaywa, pangatlo, pangapat. So, kung string rin na-compare, wow, tayo mo na mapakialam kung ano pataro second letter ni mo. String, Abby, is composed of two or more characters. So, ano gat ako ang gina-compare? First letter sa sorting. Rin doon ginagamit. Klaro? So, no need na itong iba. Next is using text formula. Yes, may formula mga students sa text. At yung nag-iisang formula na yan is ampersand. Ampersand is a symbol in formula to concatenate text strings. When we say concatenate, it simply appends the right operand at the end of the left operand. Okay. Imong left operand ag right operand. Tap. So equals left operand and right operand. Ginasugpon, tanawan nyo yung result. It simply appends the right operand at the end of the left operand. Nasugpon malang nana. So when you copy this formula, you have kap-tap. Uha, mga students. Hay, paano ma'am kung imot, ma'am, ginsugpunan? Tangan mo, di karat. Tatlong ka space, enter. Siyempre, yung result, kuha, Ayan, meron din siyang tatlong space.
Alimbawa, ready man ang cup, space that ingin butang. Tatlo, enter. O butang man, nanarot space. Ganon, yung ating concatenate symbol with each person.
Sabi ko hindi natin maabot. Naabot naman pala. But I would check your attendance muna. Okay na ito. May balita na. May Marites to sa background.
Ma'am, excuse ma'am.
Yes, Colby.
Pwede ba makapacheck at Excel, ma'am?
Sa aton lang ang work. Ay, intern naton, Colby, magpacheck.
Yes, ma'am.
May intern niya sa sugod, klase. Wata, absent, aro intern.
Yeah, ma'am.
Ato. Yeah, share screen lang. Si Oliver lang ma-check. Colby?
Wait lang, ma'am. Gawin pa, ma'am.
Si Ventura, taro nagpa-check. Naduga ta si Iliber. Sino ro pwede mag-check?
Hello, yeah, ma'am.
Una kay Iliber?
Yes, ma'am.
Gaam ko ay. The score, it kapacheck Iliber ha, 2.5.
Thank you, ma'am.
Layo, okay na yan. Ventura, okay na. Iliver, nandyan ka? Ito si Iliver. Tiyaga ka duga-duga. Tay mo. Paano naging skuran si Colby to kaina, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Tapos sino pag nagpa-check?
Si Larry. Ventura, ma'am.
Hani. Si Larry kita ko. Sino pag duga-duga. Taro signal kong ga-intern. Ya ka duga-duga.
Signal.
Wagot ka pa-check? Si Buntis ko, no?
Attendance, ma'am.
Next meeting, ma'am, po yung pamagpacheck.
Oo, galing. May minus yung room. May mga ulihi ka pa-check.
Question, ma'am. Last time.
May minus. Iya, ta si Iliver sa guwa. Got ako. Gapa-admit.
Sa next meeting lang ako, ma'am.
May, basta may minus. Ro, next meeting. Gapa-ano, ha? May minus yun the next meeting, kapacheck.
not diet talaga appear. Kasi naka-share screen ako. So next meeting, yung topic natin would be using reference formula. Ilang minutes pa kita? Less than 1 minute. Okay, bye-bye. Ha?
Bye, ma'am.
Bye-bye. Bye, ma'am.